Hi, Randy Robison here. I have with me writer John Eldredge, and we get to see something special today. We get to see a little glimpse of his new movie. That's right, John Eldredge has a movie. Let's watch his trailer right now, and then we'll talk to the man behind the film.
The human heart is made for an epic story. And when we give up looking for that story, we give up living.
A few years ago, we watched the series Long Way Round. Watching those guys ride motorcycles across the face of the planet inspired us to go out and learn to ride. And then always had this dream of maybe one day going on a trip like they did.
Don't have a background on GS bikes or off-road at all, and suddenly you get a call that the trip is happening. Not only that, we're collecting motorcycles.
It was incredible and terrifying all at the same time. It felt like we had begun stepping into the waters of something epic.
I am wildly unprepared for this.
And there was this constant fear that somewhere around me, some bike was going to go down really hard.
I can honestly say that I have never attempted anything as wild, foolish, beautiful, and bold. I've never done anything like this in my life.
We're creating something to give people insight into their whole life as a story.
I understood where they were coming from, because you can actually be so afraid of things that you can't even speak.
Airplane just takes a dive for the runway. Jet fuel spewing out, sparks going everywhere.
I look back over my shoulder, because Padre is right behind me, and I see his front tires in the air as he's going across it. And he's going off. The bike's just going straight off the ledge.
Can we as a group do this? Can we get off this mountain? And feeling like the answer was no. We can.
John, first of all, welcome.
Thank you.
Exciting. I watched the whole movie. Give the people who haven't seen it, because people hadn't seen it, tell them what the movie's about and where it's coming from, where it's going.
Yep. So too many adventure films out there have no meaning, right? We've got Red Bull this and, you know, adrenaline that and go fast, but none of it has content, especially like rich, like kingdom content. So we went out kind of on a lark, took this motorcycle trip through Colorado.
Yeah.
Dangerous. It's the movie that almost killed me.
Yeah.
Really. And we got back and we had all this footage and we went, wow, we got something really powerful here. We've got phenomenal cinematography, I think.
Yeah,
it looks
phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean it's a beautiful film.
Helicopters or just drones?
Drones.
Boy, yeah. Those are some high-reaching drones.
And they're Hollywood-grade drones. They're massive.
Okay, sorry, go ahead.
And great cinematography. Incredible epic adventure, six guys on these BMW dual sport bikes.
Very cool bikes.
Yeah, so they're on road, off road, through rivers, mountain passes. But then in the midst of this, what you have is this building content about the story of your life. Like, what's the story of your life? How do you understand your story? And so we called it A Story Worth Living.
And the thing about it is, it's not, I mean, in today's extreme sports, and you acknowledge this in the movie, you know, guys doing triple backflips is almost the norm.
Yeah, right.
Right? And you guys are all novices. You took a class before going on this.
30 days before the trip.
Right?
Yeah.
So it's not an adventure film in the sense of a Warren Miller epic, crazy,
right,
you know, stuff. It's more real in a sense. It's a very personal adventure.
Yeah.
But the thing that like you said, has the meaning and that moves it along is not so much the 1,000-mile journey, it's the stories that you tell. I want to jump back to what I think may be the central theme of the film. And it's kind of interesting because you guys are playing poker, smoking cigars, and talking about love.
Yep.
And the need for it. Where did that...
Yep.
Well, tell me why that's so central to the movie for you.
Yeah, because so what the movie does, it really takes the viewer on a journey into their own story. That's what we're trying to do. Yeah. It's not about our story, it's about your story, right? It's the story of your life. And everybody's story involves loss. And what are you going to do with that? What have you done with that? And everybody's story involves love, right? And my son, Luke, was about to propose. Mm-hmm. So it's all live time. Like, none of this is, it's reality TV. There's no script in this. You know, it's us on this adventure together, and Luke comes out with, hey, I'm going to propose to this girl. And so we're in this tiny little shack one night playing poker, and the guys are, his brothers are there on the trip, and a couple buddies, and we're talking about the human search for love, and who first broke your heart, and where's love in your life now? Because love is the center of every person's story, right? For better or for worse.
Right, or it's lack thereof, yeah.
Exactly. It's the center of the story.
Did you not know he was going to propose until he said it right there?
Uh-uh.
Really?
Yeah.
That is awesome. So he's got the wedding coming up soon.
Right, exactly. So getting married, and the story continues.
That's hysterical.
Yeah, and we did a really fun thing in the film, too, as you saw.
Do you want to really spoil it? Because that's kind of...
Oh, it's a spoiler. I guess I won't. Really great scene at the end where we surprise Luke.
Oh, that's good. Let's just tease him like that. So the movie comes out May 19th.
Yep.
Is that the release date? Yeah.
Yep, exactly.
So if you're watching this after May 19th, 2016, it means you can go find it now, and you should do that. You mentioned something to me earlier that I thought was very interesting, because you have, I see at the beginning of the film, all these sponsors with their logos,
right,
and they've helped you in the film.
Right.
Tell me, can you tell the story?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, it's a killer story.
Yeah.
Because we went out to, a couple years ago, we made a series of short films called Killing Lions.
Yep.
And you had my son, Sam, right here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I've watched them. You guys
in the show
juggled coal and things like
that. Yeah, yeah,
fire,
yeah. So it's rock climbing and mountain biking stuff out in Moab, Utah. But they were little 7-minute films. Mm-hmm. They're pretty well done. And so when we set out to do this film, we went to some of the big names in the motorcycle industry, SW Motec, Arai Helmets, Klim, riding gear. These are the guys, mm-hmm. okay? And we showed them our Lions films, and they said, hey, yeah, you guys are pretty good at this. We'd love to be a sponsor, but we're not really sure we want to be associated with a Christian movie. So here's our gear, but don't put our name on it. And so we're like, well, okay. And they said, but come back when you're done and show us the product, and we'll make up our minds. And one of the big companies was a international German company, and they were very, very leery because they have a very large Muslim clientele, and they just didn't want to, you know, put their name on something that could have been really divisive.
Sure.
Well, here's the cool story, is that sponsor after sponsor, film festivals, magazines were showing the secular world this film, and they love it. And it is opening all of these doors. Like, it's a gospel message.
Yeah,
like,
oh yeah.
You know, there's no high. And some of them are kind of like, yeah, we were surprised that it was a little religious, but we love your movie.
That's awesome.
And so they're putting their logos on it. They're putting it on their websites. They're telling the world.
That's great.
About this gospel story. It's a very cool thing.
Is this a future for you? Have we seen the last book in Moving Mountains, which I'll mention in a minute?
Yeah.
And the first film?
Maybe.
Yeah?
Maybe, yeah. My background's in theater. And when I was in my 20s, it's how my wife and I met. We were running a theater company in L.A. So this has kind of always been in my DNA.
Yeah.
People who read my books, you know, I refer to a lot of movies. I tell a lot of stories. Yeah. So I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah. Well, it's good. It's a lot of fun. Okay, if somebody doesn't know where to find it, you have locations available on your website. You're telling people how to get it.
Yeah, exactly.
Where's that at?
Yeah, so it's astoryfilm.com.
Okay.
The title of the film is A Story Worth Living. Mm-hmm. It's all about us. Everybody's looking for a story worth living. So it's astoryfilm.com, and they can find out about the movie and the festivals and all the things that are going on.
Excellent. I appreciate you. I want to mention before you get out of here, Moving Mountains is available now, John's latest book. And he's going to be talking about that extensively on Life Today, the broadcast show. If you missed that on television, you can see that at lifetoday.org after it airs. I'm going to sneak this interview out a little early before the shows air to get you some momentum, hopefully, on the film. And then do check out the website for the film. And always, for everything you're doing, johneldredge.com
yeah,
still?
Yeah, that'll get you there.
johneldredge.com.
Yeah.
Appreciate you, man.
Yeah, thanks, Randy. Thanks for having me on.
Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hit the subscribe button, because we want to let you know about all the great videos from Life Today.